Under the motto, "Hog Get Out," health and education workers are demanding he be prosecuted for his links to organized crimes.
No podemos seguir a cargo de un narco gobierno.
We can't go on being led by a narco government that is accused of receiving millions in drug money and of killing people. They don't have any morals to be in charge of our country. We are demanding his resignation.
Protesters also condemn the failure of the justice system, which has so far ignored the accusations against Juan Orlando Hernandez, which are part of the case against his brother Tony Hernandez, who was arrested in the United States for drug trafficking.
The United States is in a completely different jurisdiction. Unfortunately, here we don't have proper rule of law. It doesn't work at all. We have to wait for the U.S. Department of Justice to condemn him for drug trafficking so we can feel a little bit more relieved.
But for others, Juan Orlando Hernandez's resignation is not enough. He has to pay for all the human rights violations and corruption committing during his mandate.
Besides the trial, we are demanding his immediate ousting and that he pay for all the corruption, for the looting of our country, for all the crimes against humanity, against citizens during his mandate.
The protest ended with heavy police repression outside the National Congress, where policemen and military shot dozens of tear bombs. However, activists have assured they will remain on the streets.
Let's keep fighting, my friends. Until this dictatorship goes down, we will remain on the streets.
Despite repression, a new round of protests have been called all over the country by worker unions and civil society.